An FGCU men's basketball coach went from the sidelines to the court this week on national television.
NBC2's Jaron May explains how Shep Garner got back into the game.
Garner, deep three, and Shep Garner with the Penn State bench, loving it.
From 2014 to 2018, Shep Garner was one of the best collegiate basketball players in the country.
Garner says if you can shoot from there, so can I.
The sharpshooter played under Pat Chambers when he was the head coach at Penn State.
And I love watching him play. One of the great players in Penn State history.
Garner continued his playing career in the G League and overseas, but has now hung up the sneakers to become an assistant coach under Chambers at FGCU.
He's really passing down his experience and his words of wisdom of what he went through, and the guys really migrate to that.
Thinking his playing days were over, Shep got a call a few weeks ago from a former teammate.
As soon as he called me, I'm like, yo, I'm in.
Garner signed up to play for the Happy Valley Hoopers, a Penn State alumni team in TBT, the basketball tournament.
It was fun. You know, it was a great experience.
TBT is a yearly tournament made up of alumni teams from different schools. Players range from former NBA pros to recent grads, which meant Shep had to get back into playing shape.
It was tough at first, you know, just trying to get back into game shape.
But he got there by training with the current FGCU players.
He stoked the flame. He totally did with the guys, and the guys are all going at him, and he's going at them.
Those workouts led to Garner and his former teammates putting up a fight in the first round of TBT.
Garner all the way, lays it in.
The Happy Valley Hoopers ultimately lost, but the experience was more than that for Garner.
They got a little emotional at times. Guys cried, and it was a family affair, as it should have been.
Plus, 4 points, 3 boards, and a block for Shep, not too shabby, and he's already planning on doing it again next year.
We're definitely going to do it again, and hopefully we can bring back the money.
Reporting in Fort Myers, Jaron May, NBC2.
All new. Ahead at 5:30.